इफ यू रिमेम्बर दैट लास्ट टाइम वी पीपल वेर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट फ्रेजेस रिलेटेड टू एवरीडे इंग्लिश. सो देर आर सर्टन फ्रेजेस दैट यू पीपल कैन जस्ट रीड, गो थ्रू इट एंड ट्राई टू यूज देम इन योर कम्युनिकेशन. सो दैट वी पीपल आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू टूडे ऑल्सो. So you people just let me know whether it has done or not done. Maybe there is a possibility that it might be getting repeated. So in case if it is repeated, that time you just let me know, because for 4 or 5 class I have to teach that, and so I don't exactly remember where I have ended for your class last time. So you just be alert about that and let me know. Same for voice also. Whenever you people are not going to get the voice, that time also you people have to alert me and tell me. Okay, so let's begin. So here we people are going to see that how we people can just apologize, say sorry to people. So that we people see some phrases here. So is it audible and visible also? You people are able to see 5 phrases for apologizing. Okay, good. So whenever we people wanted to say sorry, there are different ways, and out of that different ways, here we are going to learn these 5 phrases. So first of all, you people can say, I am sorry that I was so rude yesterday. So that was the reason for saying sorry. So you people can change this example, I was so rude yesterday, and instead of that you people can use your own situation. Maybe that I did not submit the assignment, or I was not able to call you, or I forget to call you. So there could be number of other reasons, but because of that something might have happened, and so you are saying sorry. Maybe that you are saying that it is my fault. So when you say it is my fault, that time actually you are taking responsibility for the problem. So whatever the difficulty arises because of that, and it was because of you, and so you are taking responsibility of that problem, and so you are saying that it is my fault. Maybe next time you people can also use this phrase, oops sorry. So when you say oops sorry, it means that you are just referring for small problems, so they are not serious or they are not big. So there is no other such words or phrases that you people have to use. Rather than, you people can just say ops. Ops is not a word actually, this is an expression. If something happens like this, so that time we use this ops, and then you people can say sorry. Or rather than, you can tell what should have done. So maybe that right now you realized that because of what that problem arised, and so if you avoid such things, then it would not have happened. So in that case you can say, I should have called you and told you I would be late. So you can replace this example, called you and told you I would be late, rather than I should have told you about the meeting will be extended, so I will get late. But actually I did not tell you, and because of that you might have kept waiting for 1 hour. Maybe your friend is waiting for a long time and you did not reach there, and there was some other issue arisen because of that. So in that case you can say like this also. Then in formal situations, you people can say that I apologize for the delay of the submission, for delay of the report, or for any other reason also. But this is very formal, and you people have to use it in formal situations only. So in informal, you people can use all 4 above, but for formal situations you people can use this. Okay, so these were the 5 phrases that you people can use for saying sorry to someone. Normally we say I'm sorry and that is enough. we don't think much more beyond this, I'm sorry. But here you will get another choice also, and you people can think of this, and you people have to use it in your communication also. Maybe better if you note it down also. Now here another phrase or another slide is that, and it tells us that if somebody said sorry to you, and in that case how you should react to that sorry. Suppose that your friend came to you and he said sorry that I should not behave like this, or I behaved rudely with you, and he has just said sorry to you. Yes. Yes. Huh. Okay. Okay. Okay, fine. So I forgot to check that waiting room in between. So let it be. Thank you for reminding me. Now you come to the point. If you are just understood that how you can say sorry, and now you have to imagine a situation where somebody came to you and he or she is saying sorry to you, or he or she is apologizing you. So in that case, how you can respond to their sorries? So let's see. First of all, you can say that's okay. So that's okay, it means that maybe you have accepted their fault and whatever they have said sorry, and you have forgiven them. So in that case you can say that's okay. If somebody said sorry to you, you can say okay, that's okay. Like this also you can reply. Or maybe that you people can just say it happens. So when you say it happens, so what does it happen? So it happens means mistakes happen. Maybe we are all are human beings, and sometime or other everybody makes mistake. So in that case you people are just accepting this natural phenomenon of making mistakes, and you are saying that it happens. So here it happens, it means that you are just maybe forgiving that person and just counseling him or comforting him with saying this, it happens. Next you also can say no problem. So when you say no problem, it means that it is similar to that, that's okay, or it happens. So all three phrases are similar. You can use anyone, or you can also say that don't worry about it. If the person is really serious and he is saying sorry and maybe apologizing for you, so in that case you have to just give confidence to that person, and you have to just make him normal. So in that case you people can say don't worry about it. So whatever happened happened, now don't think of it, you just forget that, and you can just go ahead, start your work. Like this you people can say. Maybe you also can say I forgive you. So when you say I forgive you, this is used for some serious problems that has happened by the people, and in that case they are asking you your apology. So in that case you people can say I forgive you, and you just forgive them. So this way you people can respond to the sorry said by other people. Okay, so here you just try to understand how to say sorry also, or how to apologize. And on the other hand, if somebody apologizing to you, or if somebody is saying sorry to you, in that case how you will react to them. Okay, then next one is that here you people will just have some phrases for introductions. Introduction is an important part of our whenever we people have conversations. And maybe you are asked a number of times to introduce yourself. Maybe when you people entered in this college also, that time you people might have asked during first lectures, introduction lecture was there. So you have to introduce yourself. Maybe afterwards also during your school, maybe a college. इवन टू दोज डेज ऑल्सो यू पीपल हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ एंड नेक्स्ट इम्पोर्टेंट स्टेज विल कम दैट आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ योर ग्रेजुएशन वेन यू पीपल विल अपियर फॉर इंटरव्यू दैट टाइम ऑल्सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन asked by every interviewer is about introduction. So they may ask you introduce yourself, or they may ask you tell something us about you, or maybe they can use other words also, but entire everything, the first beginning is about introductions. So you people have to prepare your own introduction. So in introduction, normally this is our own information. It is not someone else's information that we have to present. It is our own information. It is my name, my address, or my educational qualification, my hobbies, or my family background, or everything that related to me only. But even then, people feel very nervous and they fail to introduce themselves in effective way. And that's why this first introduction, if it is in a negative way, it creates a negative impression. So whatever going to happen next, it may have negative impact. So therefore, if you remember that the phrase, it is always said that first impression is the last impression. So here you people get an opportunity to create your first impression, which can be positive, and it affects your entire interview also. So therefore, right now people just think of your own introduction, what information you are going to include in your introduction, and prepare it well. So maybe if we were in the class, we would have taken introduction also, but maybe sometimes we have to take introductions also. We will spend one more lecture on introduction also afterwards. So there you people have to tell your name or your address or everything. What points we people have to add, and how you can introduce yourself in an effective way, that we people will discuss at that time. Okay, so here you people will find some 10 phrases. So it is not only restricted for interview only, afterwards also. Suppose that you got job, so there also you people have to introduce yourself. Maybe you have to introduce your colleagues, maybe to your batch, to your team, or whatever it you you people are coming across with new people. Some conferences are there, meetings are there. So you are going to give presentation. So everywhere you people have to introduce yourself in short, in brief. So people learn how to introduce yourself. So here you people will find that here are some phrases that you people can use for introductions. And these phrases, they are for introducing yourself also. And sometimes situations come, or time is like that, you have to introduce other person also. Maybe as a manager, you people have to introduce some other supervisor, or some assistant engineer is there, and you have to introduce this to your batch or your unit. So that time you are going to introduce other person also. Maybe sometimes you are a common friend and you wanted to introduce your both of your friends to each other. So in that case also, you have to introduce other people also. So introduction is not always about yourself. Sometimes you have to introduce other persons also. So next, see what you can say. I just wanted to introduce myself. And that after that phrase, you can start, you can begin your introduction. So that introduction, you can just continue with your name, and then you people can just see additional information that you are going to add in that thing. Okay, so maybe your address, maybe your, I just talked about hobbies, or the likes, dislikes, education, or any short-term courses, long-term courses, trainings attended, etc., for the purpose of interview. Then next you can say that I don't think we have met before. My name's, okay, so you just put your name there. So maybe that you people are saying that met new strange people, or you think that you did not meet before and you are going to introduce each other, and so you are saying, I don't think we have met before, and my name is. So my name is, after that you are saying my name is Rohit Mohan Rajesh, whatever it is your name, and then you just carry on. I worked here, I work in Infosys, I work in maybe Wipro, like whatever you are just doing anything, and then you just give more details about yourself. So here one note is mentioned and it tells us that point number one and point number two are used to introduce yourself. So whenever you are going to talk about yourself, that time you can use such phrases. Then next you can use that this is. So this is you can say for yourself also, and if you are going to introduce other person in that case also. So this is Ramesh. So this is Ramesh means that you are Ramesh. So you are telling to other people, and after that you just carry on your other information. Or you just can you can say I would like to you to meet. So when you say I would like you to meet, it means that here you are going to talk about someone else. Here you are going to introduce some other people to your audience. So in that case you are saying I would like you to meet. Or you can also say, have you met, and there is a question mark. So have you met Rajesh, or have you met Rohan, have you met Ashwini, or like this you people can use here. And then you just talk more about that person. So here what you are doing actually, here you are not introducing yourself, here you are introducing to your friend or the person whom you know, and you are going to introduce that person to the audience. So maybe that also you can say, I would like to introduce you to. So this phrase is also used for introducing someone else. Okay. So people think that there might be time that you people have to introduce other people. So in that case, you people can use such phrases. Then next, you people can say, nice to meet you. So when you can say nice to meet you, so earlier you met. I told you that you are just newly meet each other. Or you are strangers earlier and you have introduced yourself. You introduce yourself to that person and that person introduced yourself, and you had some chatting, gossips, and after that gossips, you people are going to take leave. You are saying goodbye to each other. So in that case, you are just saying that nice to meet you. Or maybe after meeting, you people say nice to talk to you or nice to meet you. So in this case, if you say nice to meet you, it means that you are happy to meet that person. Or also you people can say it's a pleasure to meet you. So both are similar, nice to meet you or it's a pleasure to meet you. Both sentences can be used. And also you people can say likewise. So when you can say likewise, if somebody said to you nice to meet you, so reply to that nice to meet you, you can say likewise. So what does it mean likewise? It means also that I also feel nice to meet you. Or also you can say and you. So and you is reply to this, it's a pleasure to meet you. So these are the some points, phrases that you people just pick up. There are much more. These are just I have put as a example, but if you find, you'll get more words, more phrases for introduction, or better you just search it on Google, internet, YouTube, everywhere you will get plenty of more information, and you just try to make your introduction. Okay, so somebody has joined with name electrical. So what does it mean electrical? So are you direct second year students? In that case, you people have to mention DSY and then you people have to put your name. Okay. So you just people get more information and try to make introduction more unique. It should not be like everyone else. Your introduction should be different than others. So you just try to get more phrases for your introduction. You try to get more words for your introduction. Then next point is about six ways to show interest. So suppose that you people are just going to listen someone, So if you are listening them and you like it, you are just showing interest. So how you can show interest? What are the words that you people can use which will show that you are really interested in their speech? You are really listening to them. Okay, so in that case you people can use these phrases. So first of all, you people can say really. So when you say really, it means that you actually listening and the whatever the information you are getting, it is really unbelievable. And so you are saying really. Next, you people can also say that's interesting. So when you say that's interesting, at that time it means that you are interested to listen to that person. Then next you can say So that is not word actually, it is the expression that you are showing you are listening. Maybe in our mother tongue also we give some responses like this. So this it means that you are listening to that person. ज्याला होकार देणे म्हणतो आपण, हो हो म्हणतो की नाही मराठीमधून वगैरे असं. फॉर दॅट यू पीपल कॅन यूज इट. यू ऑल्सो कॅन यूज राईट. सो राईट मीन्स दॅट यू आर ॲग्रिंग विथ दॅट पर्सन ऑर यू आर जस्ट गिविंग रिस्पॉन्स टू दॅट पर्सन. ऑर यू पीपल कॅन ऑल्सो यूज दिस वर्ड्स, बट इट इज यूज्ड बाय नेटिव स्पीकर्स. सो बी अवेअर अबाउट दिस. This is gotcha. Gotcha, it means meaning is got you. Got you means understand you. So whatever you told, I understand it. But this expression is used by native speakers. Or you people can also say that sure. Okay, so this way you people can just show interest in listening to other people. So all these phrases you can use to show the other person that you are listening. Okay, so is it audible still or visible? Awaaz vagare yetoy ka aikala, or is it okay, are you getting my voice?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we will go to next point. So here you people, how you can end the conversation? Maybe sometimes see that you people are talking with your friends and meanwhile you people have to take their leave, or you people wanted to say goodbye to that people because you have some urgent work, or you people have to complete your task, assignment, something. So that time, how you can ask to that person that you wanted to go or you wanted to leave? So that means how to end a conversation politely. So here you will learn these five phrases and you people can use them. So when you wanted to take leave, at that time you can say, it was nice chatting with you. So when you say it was nice chatting it with you, it that now you want to close that chatting. Okay, just wait a minute, we will just finish, we'll complete this point and then we'll stop. So maybe we will have quiz afterwards rather. So you can say it was nice chatting with you, or you people can say, well, it's getting late. So when you say, well, it's getting late, it means that right now you wanted to close that conversation and you wanted to go because you're getting late. Or you people also can say, anyway, I should get going. So when you say get going, it means that to leave or to depart. Then next you can say in formal way, sorry, but I'm afraid I need to. So after I need to, you have to tell the reason why you wanted to quit or stop that conversation. So I need to go to my office. I need to complete my task. I need to complete my assignment. I have to work on my project. So these will be some reasons that you people can use after to. So remember here, when you say I am afraid, it does not mean that you really have some fear. It is not related to having fear. It means that you wanted to be formal and saying sorry because now you are going to close it. So that afraid, the meaning of afraid we know is that is fear, but it is not fear here. Or you can also say that I am sorry to cut you off, but I actually got a run. So this got a run is an American English. It means got to run. So cut you off, it means to interrupt. So if some person is talking and in between you wanted to stop that or interrupted to that person and you wanted to go from there. So in that case, you people can say this. Okay. So just wait for 1 minute. I will share the link for quiz. So today we people will have quiz based on adjectives. Okay.